The gates and doors were barred, and all the windows fastened down. I spent the night in sleeplessness, rose at every sound, half in hopeless sorrow, half in fear the day would find the soldiers crashing through to drag us all away. Just before the sunrise, I heard something out the wall. The gate began to rattle, and a voice began to call. I hurried to the window, looked out into the street, expecting swords and torches and the sounds of soldiers' feet. Well, there was no one there but Mary, so I went down to let her in. John stood there beside me as he told us where she'd been. She said they moved him in the night, and none of us knows where. The stone's been rolled away, and now his body isn't there. Well, we both ran towards the car, then John ran on ahead, and he found the stone that he gave you to, just the way that Mary said. And the binding sheet they wrapped him in was just an empty shell. Then where or why they'd taken him was more than we could tell. Well, something strange had happened, but just what we didn't know. John believed a miracle, but I just turned to go. Circumstance and speculation couldn't lift me very high. For I'd seen them crucify him, then I watched him die. Back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. Everything I promised him added to my shame. When at last it came, the choice was even if he were alive, it wouldn't be the same.